Hello everyone. So today we are going to learn about the protoplast culture and stomatic hybridization part 2. So in our previous video, we learned about the protoplast culture, then how the protoplast culture is carried out, what are the historical development, what is the enzymatic method and the mechanical method. Then we also learned about the what is the concept of hybridization, then the stomatic hybridization, and then we learned in detail about that. So today we are going to learn about the culture of protoplast. If you have not gone through that video, I would suggest that you just watch that video so that you will be able to get the conceptual clarity and you will be able to understand in more detail about the protoplast culture and the stomatic hybridization. So today what we are going to learn is the culture of protoplast. So the very first step in protoplast culture is the development of a cell wall that is takes place around the cell membrane of the protoplast. So this first step is the development of cell wall around the cell membrane of the protoplast, and it is followed by the cell divisions that give rise to a small colony. So the cell division gives rise to the small colony, it is followed by that. Now, with the suitable manipulations of the nutritional and the physical conditions, the cell colonies may be grown continuously as cultures or regenerated to whole plants. Protoplasts are cultured either in the semi-solid medium or semi-solid agar or in the liquid medium. And the protoplasts are first allowed to develop cell wall in liquid medium, and then they are transferred to the agar medium at some times. So the protoplasts are first allowed to develop cell wall into the liquid medium, and then they are transferred to the agar medium. So this is the culture of protoplast. Then we'll learn in more detail about the agar culture. Now, what is agar culture exactly? So agar culture. Agarose, it is the most frequently used agar to solidify the culture media. And the concentration of the agar, it should be such that it forms a soft agar gel when it is mixed with the protoplast suspension. So the plating of the protoplast is carried out by the Bergman's cell plating technique. In agar cultures, the protoplasts remain in a fixed position and they divide and form the cell clones. So the advantage with agar culture is that the clumping of protoplast is avoided. So the agar culture is used more widely. Then the liquid culture. Now liquid culture, it is the preferred method for the protoplast cultivation because it is easy to dilute and transfer. Then the density of cells can be manipulated as desired. And so for some of the plant species, the cell cannot divide in agar medium. So the liquid medium is the only choice. And the osmotic pressure of the liquid medium can be altered as desired. So the liquid medium is preferred. Now coming to the culture media. The culture media with regard to the cultural components, nutritional components and the osmotic, they depend on that. So culture media, what is important? The nutritional components and the osmotic pressure. So the nutritional requirement of protoplasts are similar to that of the cultured plant cells like the suspension culture and the callus culture. Now we know that the MS media, it is the most widely used media, and the B5 media with suitable modifications are used. So there are some special features of protoplast culture media. First, that the medium should be devoid of ammonium and the quantities of the iron and zinc should be less in the protoplast culture. The other one is the concentration of calcium should be 2 to 4 times higher than that used for the cell culture. This is needed because of the to get the membrane stability. Then the high oxygen phytokinin ratio is suitable to induce the cell divisions, while the high cytokinin oxygen ratio is required for regeneration. So this is the third one. Fourth one is the glucose is preferred carbon source by protoplast, although a combination of sugars like glucose and sucrose can be used. Then the fifth one is the vitamins used for protoplast culture are the same as that are used in the standard tissue culture media. So these are five important nutritional components of the protoplast culture. Now coming to osmoticum and osmotic pressure. Now osmoticum, what it is exactly, it refers to the reagents or the chemicals that are added to increase the osmotic pressure of the liquid. Now in order to increase the osmotic pressure of the liquid, chemicals or reagents are added. That is called as osmoticum. So the isolation and culture of protoplast requires osmotic protection until they develop a strong cell wall. So if the freshly isolated protoplasts are directly added to the normal culture medium, they will burst. So addition of the osmoticum is essential for both the isolation and the culture media of protoplast to prevent the rupture. So there are two types of osmotica. One is the one non-ionic and the other one is ionic osmotica. So non-ionic osmotica, now what is it is? The non-ionic substances like the soluble carbohydrates such as the glucose, fructose, sorbitol, sucrose, galactose, mannitol. Mannitol, it is being metabolically inert, it is mostly used. So this is non-ionic osmotica, and the ionic osmotica is the potassium chloride, calcium chloride, magnesium phosphate. These are used. So what they do, they help to maintain the osmotic pressure. So ionic osmotica and non-ionic osmotica. Now when the protoplasts are transferred to a culture medium, the use of metabolically active osmotic stabilizers, example the glucose or sucrose, along with the metabolically inert osmotic stabilizers, that is mannitol, is advantageous. And as the growth of protoplast and cell wall regeneration occurs, the metabolically active compounds are utilized so that it helps to reduce the osmotic pressure to get the proper osmolarity, and the osmolarity is maintained over there. So this is about the osmotic pressure and the osmotic osmoticum. Now in the further video, we'll learn more about the culture method, what is feeder layer technique, then the co-culture of protoplast, micro-drop culture, and then we learn about the regeneration of protoplast, fusion of protoplast, somatic hybridization. So stay tuned for more lessons to come. And if you like the video, don't forget to click on thumbs up button below. And also don't forget to subscribe to get more updates. And thank you for watching.